Hello viewers, in this class we will study about azeotropic mixtures. What are azeotropic mixtures? These are the solutions of one solute and one solvent, which means they are binary solutions. There is only one solute and one solvent, and there is fixed composition of solute and solvent in solution. This is the second characteristic. The third characteristic is that the mixture boils at constant temperature. Fourth characteristic is fractional distillation is not possible. We cannot separate solute and solvent using the fractional distillation method. What is fractional distillation method? We will see in just now. And now we study what is the fifth characteristic of azeotropic mixture. Fifth characteristic is that composition of two components. What are two components? One is solute and other is solvent. The composition of two components is same in liquid as well as in vapor phase. If there are two components A and B, then xA, zeta A, mole fraction of A in liquid phase is equal to yA, mole fraction of A in vapor phase. This is liquid phase and this is vapor phase. They both are same, and for B component XB is equal to YB. This is liquid phase, mole fraction in liquid phase, and this is vapor mole fraction in vapor phase. So both the components have same composition, same mole fraction in liquid phase as well as vapor phase. These are the five characteristics of azeotropic mixtures. See, what is fractional distillation? Fractional distillation is that if we have mixture of two components let it be A plus B. A and B are two components of this solution, and let boiling point of A is 300 Kelvin and boiling point of B is 400 Kelvin. Now we insert a tube here, and this tube is connected with another container here. Now we start heating this container containing A plus B, containing mixture of A and B component. When the temperature of this mixture reaches 300 Kelvin, what happens? The component A starts vaporizing, and that is vapors through this tube goes to this container, this vessel, and here they are condensed, and here the A component is collected in this vessel. And as the temperature was 300 K, B, whose boiling point was 400 Kelvin, that could not be evaporated at 300 K. So the B liquid will remain here and A will be here. This is fractional distillation. We used the difference in boiling point to separate the two components. But in case of azeotropic mixtures, what happens? They boil at the same temperature. So fractional distillation is not possible in that case, azeotropic mixtures. Now we come on to the another property of azeotropic mixtures. See, azeotropic mixtures, we have studied Raoult law. And positive deviation and negative deviation from the Raoult law. In case of positive deviation, we get azeotropic mixture, and that mixture is called minimum boiling point azeotropic mixture. Azeotropic mixture. And in case of negative deviation from Raoult law, we get azeotropic mixture, which is maximum boiling point azeotropic mixture. So there are two types of azeotropic mixtures. One is minimum boiling point of azeotropic mixture and other is maximum boiling point azeotropic mixture. Minimum boiling point azeotropic mixture is due to positive deviation from Raoult law, and maximum boiling point azeotropic mixture is due to negative deviation from the Raoult law. Now we will study that how these two mixtures are formed. See, when there is 95% solution of C2H5OH ethanol. This is the azeotropic mixture with positive deviation or minimum boiling point azeotropic mixture. We just see that how it is form, it forms minimum boiling point azeotropic mixture. Now see, here we draw a graph here. Mole fraction of water is 0 and mole fraction of ethyl alcohol or ethanol is 1. This is mole fraction. And here the mole fraction of water is 1 and mole fraction of ethanol is 0. Here no water is there, only ethyl alcohol at this point. Only ethyl alcohol or ethanol is present. The boiling point, this is vapor pressure. This is the line which shows vapor pressure according to Raoult law if they are ideal solution, but they are not ideal. They show positive deviation. So the graph will be like this. Here the maximum VP, maximum vapor pressure, he is at the at this point. Corresponding to this point, there will be we draw another graph here, which is mole fraction in on the same axis with the same marking, and here it we have taken boiling point, the point at which the vapor pressure is maximum. Is the boiling point, and the boiling point here, the boiling point of ethyl alcohol 353, and here the boiling point of water, because at this point only water is there, ethyl alcohol is 0, mole fraction of ethyl alcohol is 0, ethanol is 0. So water, boiling point of water is 373, and the solution mixture of the two shows the boiling point and mole fraction graph as at the point of maximum vapor pressure, the boiling point of the solution is given, and at this point where the vapor pressure is maximum, this is 5% of water and 95% of ethanol. At this composition, the azeotropic mixture is formed, and its boiling point is less than the individual boiling points of the two components. It is somewhere here, and it is actually equal to 351. See, 353 is the boiling point of ethanol when it is in pure form, and 373 is the boiling point of water when it is in pure form. So the mixture of two, azeotropic mixture of two, the boiling point of the azeotropic mixture is 351, and the composition at which the azeotropic mixture is formed is 5% of H2O and 95% of ethane. So this is the graph by which the formation of azeotropic mixture is explained with positive deviation. Now we take the other example, which is the maximum boiling point. This is minimum boiling point, because the boiling point is less than the boiling points of both the solute and solvent. But in this case, maximum boiling point azeotropic, the boiling point of the azeotropic mixture is more than the boiling point of each component. Let us see with the help of graph how it happens. First we draw a graph another thing is that example of this azeotropic solution is HNO3 solution, aqueous solution of HNO3. See, this is vapor pressure, this is mole fraction. Here the mole fraction of HNO3 is equal to 1, and mole fraction of H2O is 0. Here mole fraction HNO3 is equal to 0, and mole fraction of H2O is equal to 1. Same as we have taken in this example also. Here only HNO3 is present. No mole fraction of water is 0, and at this point mole fraction of HNO3 is 0 and only water is present. So the vapor pressure graph as shown by Raoult law will be straight line, but this is not ideal solution and there is negative deviation from the Raoult's law, and the graph is of vapor pressure is. So here this is the minimum vapor pressure. At minimum vapor pressure, the boiling point of the azeotropic mixture, this is the azeotropic mixture, 68% here, 68% of HNO3 and 32% of water composition, by composition, this is the 68% HNO3 and 32% H2O. And corresponding to this point, if we take another graph, this is mole fraction, this is boiling point in temperature, temperature, boiling point temperature. Then here the boiling point of HNO3 only, here boiling point of water only, 373, and HNO3, the boiling point of HNO3 is 356, and the graph comes as here the maximum point is the boiling point of the azeotropic mixture. This is 393.5. See, this boiling point is more than the boiling point of HNO3, more than the boiling point of water. So this is maximum boiling point azeotropic mixture in case of negative deviation. The maximum boiling point azeotropic mixture is formed, and in case of positive deviation, minimum boiling point azeotropic mixture is formed. In our next class, we shall take colligative properties and how those properties are demonstrated by the solutions. Thank you for watching the video.